Hi guys, this YouTube is for my female Muslim friends on YouTube. I'm so happy to see so many ladies are making YouTubes now because so many Islamic teachings say that, your mouth is a private part and it's awra, so you shouldn't even be talking. So I'm glad to see that a lot of you don't feel that way. And I want to talk about what's going on up in your anticipated heaven. Many Muslims are excited to get up there, anticipate, having things like 72 virgins and, getting busy. And, this is apparently, even Muslim men are killing themselves for, right? So I want to know what you're going to do and, who's the whores up there? Lots to talk about. Anyway, let's start here. I'll make another YouTube later just talking about the whores and Jannah and stuff. This one here says, Ibn Kathir mentions Muhammad is saying that men in heaven would have sex with 100 virgins in a day. And, what do you Muslim ladies think about that? Are you happy that your husbands are going to be off doing that kind of stuff? I don't know. Anyway, you tell me, let me know in comments, all right? In another version of the hadith, Muhammad is reported to have said, in paradise, the believers will be given such and such strength for women. Anna said, I asked, oh, Allah's messenger, will one be able to do that? And he said, he will be given the strength of 100 men. Rawr. I guess it's rawr for some of you Muslim women, but, maybe other women, they anticipate, more out of heaven than just the animal actions that men, crave here on earth. I don't know. Okay, so you can let me know what you think. Some companions of Muhammad are reported to have said that the men in heaven will be busy deflowering virgins. This is a little offensive for me, and I want to know what you Muslim ladies think about, your dad running off deflowering virgins on your mom, and your brother running through the neighborhood up there deflowering the virgins. It's a hard visual. Okay, let's go on. Ibn Kathir says that the hore are delightful virgins of comparable age who never had sexual intercourse with anyone, whether being from mankind or jinn. This is very interesting, because I read hadith here that Muhammad said that jinns, they float around the ceilings of your houses, and I think it's frightening for you Muslim ladies. I mean, what happens if you're watching TV, you've got a horror show on, you look up, there's a jinn staring at you from the ceiling, I don't know, it would just be like a nightmare. I want to know if any of you ladies have experienced that, and what's it feel like. The other thing is Muhammad said that jinns can come into your bedrooms and they can have sex with you. And this is like a big shock for me to even read that. So I want to know, have any of you Muslim women, have you had sex with jinns? And I'm not getting personal about this. I want to see about, we should get a network happening and counseling, and, we should open this up for a lot of dialogue, because it would be a traumatic experience. I'm sure that, women would want to get some support services for something crazy like this thing. I mean, whew, imagine. So let's have dialogue, guys. Post me dialogue in my YouTube and let's talk about it before their husbands. Let's move on. By commenting in their life after they become old in this life, they were brought back while virgin, youthful, being delightfully passionate with their husbands, beautiful, kind, and cheerful. I took this as an insult when I read this, because aren't you already beautiful? Aren't you already kind and cheerful and passionate? I mean, wow, why do they have to put delightfully in there? It's almost as if, this is a word inserted for the guy's benefit, for sure. Just, what do those men want? Huh? They want a delightfully passionate woman. I don't know. I think it's an insult because, here Allah is going to refashion you this way. And yet I read hadith where Muhammad, he said that he looked into hell and he saw that most of the inhabitants were women. and they were there because they were ungrateful to their husbands. And I thought that that was kind of nasty. But I read other hadiths that said that a woman, you know, a Muslim woman, she should prostrate before her husband, even before her God. She should even lick his nose. And I read that Muhammad, he said that women are deficient in the mind and in the religion. You know, like, really knocking you guys. I don't know. You guys tell me what you think about that. Let's read on. Each time we sleep with a whore, we find her virgin. Besides, the penis of the elected is never softens. Okay. No comment. The erection is eternal. You know, the only thing I could say about this is, did this come from some man's mind? You know, like, did Muhammad just think of these things all the time? Because the only thing it reminds me of, a hadith, he said that it will rain sperm up in heaven. You know, I don't know, I want your opinion, you ladies, because I'm a Christian, and as I said, I'm not going to this heaven. My heaven is totally different than your heaven. So we're going to two different places. I want your opinion about that. Let's go on. The sensation that you feel each time you make love is utterly delicious and out of this world. And were you to experience it in this world, you would faint. Okay. This is for the guys, obviously, because I guess they're going to be so excited. It's going to be so powerful up there that they would faint if they had it here on earth. Whoop-de-doo. Now I can see why your men are so excited to get up there. Anyway, let's go on. Each chosen one will marry 70 whores besides the women he married on earth, and she will have appetizing vaginas. Okay. I don't want to talk about this one. In another place, Ibn Kathir emphasizes the literal nature of sexual intercourse in paradise by another hadith. The Prophet, peace be upon him, was asked, do we have sex in paradise? He answered, yes, by Satan, who holds my soul in his hand. And it will be done, the intercourse will be done with much shove and disturbance. So you're going to even have violent sex up there. You know, it's going to be very lusty or violent. And okay, and when it's finished, she's going to turn virgin and pure again. So Muslim ladies, you know, that's it? That's your heaven? I read a hadith said that your Allah, he walks amongst the couches and he watches you in your pleasure. And these couches are arranged in rows facing each other. You know, here on earth, what comes into my mind as a visual is like voyeurism. I don't even know what that is. Voyeurism. You know, like, is Allah a voyager? Are you guys voyagers up there? I don't know. Anyway, like I said, let's open dialogue, see what's going on, because my heaven is a different place. I want to know your thoughts about your heaven. Okay, and here's my source for this. As you see, I personally have never used this source before. I don't care for it, but Muslims always use it as a source for their references. I couldn't name how many have used this as evidence for their faith. And there's everywhere has little links you can click on to read and get your verification, I suppose. But I would still check it, of course. Double check a source like this. Anyway, can't wait to hear from you ladies, you Muslim ladies. This is your YouTube. So catch you later.